This is our third and fourth graders. There's a little change in the program.
The story of the candy cane.
Well, there was something new at the candy cane store, something that no one had ever seen before.
The candy maker was anxious to share his holiday treat with everyone there. He held up a red and white peppermint stick. The children all wanted to give a look. I made this candy, he explained that day. I shaped it to look like the letter J.
J is where Jesus God sent his son to earth, and Christmas is when we remember his birth.
But when I turned the cane around to make the letter go upside down,
it looks like a staff that the shepherd used. They were the first to hear the good news.
As the shepherd was watching the sheep that night, the sky was filled with the heavenly light. Angels appeared and started talking, "Glory to God, our newborn king."
Were filled with wonder and joy as they they knelt beside the baby boy. The white on the candy is there to show that when we're forgiven, we're white as the snow. Jesus was born to save us from sin, to make us holy and clean within.
I add the stripes to remember the day that Jesus washed all of our sins away.
He died on the cross, his blood was shed. That's why the stripes are golden red.
I wanted to share this story with you so Jesus can be your Savior too.
There's a little change in the program, so we'll have the fifth graders go now.
The fifth grade class would like to introduce the littlest Christmas tree. The littlest Christmas tree stood on the hill wondering still.
Will I be chosen this year?
Don't worry, dear, you may be chosen this year.
Will I be chosen this year?
Bough bent and broken by the wind and by the storm, the littlest Christmas tree had an uneven form. Splintered and rejected by all who passed by, the littlest Christmas tree began to cry.
Don't cry, little tree. How would you have known that you were going to grow year after year?
Little tree, don't cry, said a squirrel nearby. Then a blue jay, a chickadee, an owl, wise and strong, a cardinal, a woodpecker, with a beak very long, flew onto the tree and burst into song. Oh thank you, my friends, you are dear. Now I'll be chosen this year. The littlest Christmas tree was happy that day till a lightning and thunder drove his friends away. The kind mother tree was taken that night by a family who rode in his sleigh. She offered these words of comfort before she was carried away.
A Christmas tree's purpose is to bring love and joy to every on Christmas to every boy and girl. So have faith, my dear. Your chance will come, and you may be chosen someday.
All alone in the night, beneath stars glowing bright, all the tree looked toward heaven for light. A star sailing by the twinkling sky shined its light on the littlest tree. As it bathed in the light on that one special night, the tree heard a voice say aloud.
Because you are bent, broken, and small, you are the most beloved of all. For the love that's inside is a gift that you hide. Let it shine forth this night.
And the light from above rekindled the love deep inside the littlest tree. The hill glowed that night, for the tree's love shined bright, and happiness fell all around. When spring came at last, the trees on the hill,
on the hill, the littlest Christmas tree was wondering still.
Will I be chosen this year?
When summertime came and the other trees grew, the littlest Christmas tree wandered anew.
Will I be chosen this year?
And would you believe that on Christmas Eve, the littlest tree looked towards heaven, and the light from a star in the heavens so far caused the littlest tree to remember the light from above and its message of love. On that special night of last December, and the hill glowed that night, for the tree's love shined bright and happiness fell all around.
Oh, Father, dear Father, please look over there.
That is the one. It's so lovely, my dear. We'll bring it home for Christmas.
So the littlest Christmas tree went home at last, embraced in the little child's care.
Dear little tree, you're just like me.
And the tree shined that night with its message of light and happiness fell all around.
Oh, Christmas tree, how lovely are your branches. Oh, Christmas tree, you fill our hearts with gladness. Merry Christmas.
This time we're going to receive our Sunday school offering. So the fellows who I asked to come and help us come. Before we get Bill playing here, let's pray and thank God. Heavenly Father, thank you for these kids, for their families. And bless us now even as we receive these gifts. In your name we pray. Amen.
Before I start, I have something for Stephen. Stephen's been practicing hard to learn to play the harmonica. The harmonica is the same keys that's on a piano. They're through A and G all the way through. So tonight, Stephen gets a full set of harmonicas.
now have the kindergarten, first, and second grade class.
What can I do?
Mr. Know-it-all. That kid has a heart attack.
Hi.
Scary out here.
Seeing animals yet?
Lots of stars out tonight.
There's a really bright one over there.
Boy, it is a bright one, Squirt. Count on you to see it.
Oh, I love looking at the stars, and that's the brightest one I've ever seen.
The reason I didn't come out with you is because Father took me to the synagogue to worship with him.
Well, aren't you special?
Yes, I am. Now, let me tell you, it was really interesting. The rabbis were talking about how a Savior will come and rescue us from the Romans. He will come and set us free. We read about him from the Torah, and everyone got real excited. It was very interesting.
He will have to be very powerful. The Romans have so many soldiers.
And they're mean, and they take our money, and we can't have anything. I hate the way they are.
So when is the Savior coming? Soon, I hope.
The rabbis didn't say. Father says things are so bad, he must be coming soon. They kept calling the Savior the Messiah.
I agree. I don't believe it will happen. There's no hope.
Well, I believe.
Oh, Squirt, you're too young to know what you believe.
I do so believe. Something inside me tells me it's true.
I'd be happy if someone saved me from these dumb sheep.
Well, it's getting late. Let's get some sleep. Everything seems quiet in Amos. Just keep you warm.
Are you
Me too. Do you think it's Robert or maybe Nana?
Wait a minute. It sounds like music. Music? So you did, Squirt. So you did.
Well, let's go to Bethlehem and see this baby like the angel said.
Yes! Let's go!
God has heard the prayers of people, but we're just shepherds. What can we do for the baby?
We can tell others the good news.
The story about the baby Messiah so long ago is still good news today. And what can we do? We can tell others the good news just as the shepherds and the followers of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, have said throughout the ages. Let us continue telling the good news the Messiah has come.
Christmas tree, oh Christmas tree, how lovely are my branches.
What are you happy about? All you have to do is stand there.
Yes, but I have a very important job. I stand here proudly reminding everyone the reason for the season.
Which is?
I forgot. Oh, well, what's wrong with you?
I'm really mad at Angel. She thinks she's so perfect. I told her I was going to sit on top of your branches, on your top branches, this year. And she said, one of my points is Bennett, so she's going to be the main attraction.
Now, wait a minute. You both know I'm the main attraction.
But without us, you'd just be a plain old green tree. You need us, admit it. Whatever.
There you are. I've been looking all over for you.
What's wrong, Angel? Up in the air about something again?
Very funny. Thanks to you, I'll be tossed in the trash dumpster this year. What did you do with my halo?
What? It wasn't real.
Just give it back.
Can't do it.
What do you mean you can't do it? Why not?
Well, so I sort of dropped it, and it got stuck in the vacuum cleaner.
Oh no! My shiny halo!
You what? Tickle me to death with you. Hey, Angel, how many halos does it take to break a vacuum cleaner? One.
Now, where was I? Oh, yes. Oh, Christmas tree, how lovely are my...
Hello, how are you, tree? Isn't it a wonderful day?
Who made you the official leader?
Well, nobody exactly. It's just, I have this sunny personality, I guess. Did I mention what a wonderful day it is?
Holy 852 times.
Oh, well, did I mention that you look extremely lovely today?
No. Thanks. I think.
Isn't it exciting? Christmas? With the snow? The logs on the fireplace?
We don't have a fireplace.
Oh, I know. But if we did, wouldn't it be great? Life is so good. Life is so wonderful.
Life stinks.
Excuse me?
I said life stinks.
Oh, sure. It's fine if you're a tree or a carter. You guys get all the best jobs, but for us candy canes, it's miserable. First, they wrap you in a hot cellophane. Then, they hang you on a tree next to a light, so you'll be sure to melt for Christmas. Or they give you to some dirty-faced, grubby kid who slobbers all over you. Or, if you're one of the really lucky ones, you get a ribbon tied around your neck real tight. And bam! You're stuck to a present.
Did someone call?
Oh, what a lovely ensemble! You look radiant! How are the children?
Oh, brother, don't encourage her. She's already wrapped up in herself.
Well done. Aren't you sweet? When you look this good, it's hard to be humble.
Oh, yeah. I bet you're tied together with a big watch tape.
Here's the thought. My Scotch friend invisible tape came directly from the mall. My specialty paper is sold exclusively at the Christmas store. And, just in case you were wondering, my bow was handmade with the finest ribbon available to man. Only the biggest, the brightest, the best. That's my motto, you know.
I thought your motto was, tacky is as tacky does.
That was last week, darling. Get with the program.
Hello, everyone. Did you hear the latest? Tree was singing to himself again. Star's mad because his coin is broken. Angel lost her halo. The vacuum cleaner is broken. And Kate feels miserable. Cardiff will flatter everyone, and Crescent is spotting herself again and again.
And Belle is gossiping again.
Oh, it's not gossip if it's true, silly. And besides, I'm not saying anything behind your back that I wouldn't say to your faces.
Actually, Belle, repeating what you hear and see is gossip.
Oh, don't worry, Tree. I won't repeat any of it. I only tell it once.
Oh, don't pay any mind to them, dear. It takes a certain kind of person to appreciate good news. Come on, let's take a little stroll and chat for a while.
Well, Kane, isn't there some place you need to be? I have to spruce up a little bit. It is Christmas Eve, you know.
Yeah, I guess I'll just go jump in a candy bowl somewhere and wait to be broken up and slurped on for something.
Christmas tree.
Oh, woe is me, oh, woe is me.
Oh, put a sock in it, will ya?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to mess up your song, but I'm always messing up everything anyway.
What do you mean? How could you mess anything up?
Oh, so now you're saying I'm not important to mess anything up.
That's not what I meant at all. I just meant...
It's okay, I'll just go over here and hide in a corner. Wait till the celebrates me over. I wouldn't want to get in anybody's way or anything.
Oh, great. How am I supposed to get ready for the big night with that old empty sock's lying around here? Well, maybe no one will see her over there in the dark. Oh, Christmas tree, how the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine.
Who are you?
Oh, don't be alarmed. It's just me, and I've never seen you around here before.
No. Every year the family buys one new thing to add to their Christmas stuff. This year, I guess I get to be the new thing.
Just great. Now I have to explain to somebody else why I'm the main attraction around here.
I already know what's so special about you, Tree.
You do?
Of course. Everybody knows what's so special about you.
They do? They do. But just to be sure you know why I'm special, tell me.
Because evergreen trees are green and alive all year round. They represent everlasting life.
Oh yeah, I knew that. But just to refresh my memory, why is everlasting life so important at Christmas time?
I know what my mom and dad say. They say it's because Jesus, the giver of eternal life, was born on Christmas.
That's right. Your mom and dad are right. Do you know why you are so important, Stocky?
I'm not special. I'm just empty.
You're empty for a reason. You're going to be filled with treats and toys for the children tonight. You're going to be the first thing they reach for in the morning.
I am?
Yes. You show that even the emptiest heart can be filled to the top with Jesus' love.
Wow, I never knew that before. I thought it gets back to my place. Thanks, Kendall. I'll never forget this.
So, Kendall, have you met the rest of the gang yet?
No, actually, I just got here a little while ago.
Well, let me introduce you to them. Kane should be in the next room. Kane? That's strange. She was just here a few minutes ago. Maybe Carr's still around. Carr!
Hello, Tree. Who's your friend?
It's very nice to meet you. I'm Carr. I'm the official greeter. My goodness, you are so bright and cheerful.
Thank you, Carr. It's nice to meet you, too.
Carr, why don't you round up the others so Cannon can meet them?
Okay. Angel! Boo! Kid! Present! Come in here, please!
I could have done that.
Oh, heavens. What is it? It's not time for the celebration yet, is it? Bella and I were just catching up on the latest news!
Guess what, everyone? There's a new kid in town, and I hear he's very bright.
Hello, you must be Belle. I'm Kendall, the new kid.
Oh, hello. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to,
It's okay, Belle. I know you have to talk all the time. It's your job.
It is? I have a job?
Yes. Tomorrow morning, people will know it's Christmas because all the church bells will ring out loud and clear. And all the little bells like you will jingle and jingle.
If you can hear the jingle of the bells yakking.
Now, Tree, I'm sure Belle's just excited and doesn't know what to do with all her energy.
That's right. I never realized it before, but that's why I always tell everything I know. But now I'm just going to jingle the good news about Christmas everywhere I go. What's Christmas job, Kendall?
Job? I don't have a job. I'm merely here to please the eye. I look good. It's what I do. It's all I do.
Present, I can't believe you think that's all you're here for. You do have a job. Your job is to represent the greatest gift ever given.
It is?
Yes. Jesus was God's gift to the world, and that's why people give gifts to each other at Christmas time. It's not the pretty paper and bows, it's the love that counts.
Hey, everybody. Where's Kane?
Yeah, where's Kane? Never mind about Star. Hey, who's the new kid? Oh, I see how it is. The star's got a broken point, so we're gonna get a new light around here, huh?
At least you've got all your parts.
Still better about the halo thing, Angel? So you think you're gonna take my place, huh? You and whose army?
Oh no, Star. I can never replace you. You stand for the greatest light that led wise men to Jesus. You remind people that wise men are and women still see Jesus.
I do? I mean, I do. So, what are you here for?
Well, I'm not exactly sure. I know God has a purpose for me, but I was hoping someone here could tell me what it is.
Maybe Kane would know. Where is she? I've been very worried about her lately.
I don't know, but we saw a kid with something sticky all over his face.
I can't believe I've been so selfish. I'm worried about a missing halo and Kane's gone. What kind of angel are you if people can't tell you're an angel when your halo's not on? I wish Kane were here.
I tell him how he's so important because his red stripes remind people of Jesus' blood that was shed. I tell him that he's shaped like the letter J for Jesus. I tell him that I miss him. And
Angel?
What? Who's there?
Angel, it's me, Kane. I found something for you. A little bit, but here it is.
You found my halo! Thank you! Thank you so much!
Do the others miss me, Angel? Really miss me?
Yes, very much. And there's a new kid.
My fault.
Let us now celebrate the Swedish Christmas tradition, Saint Lucia Day. The legend was carried from Italy to northern Sweden during medieval times, before the Reformation. In Sweden, the days before Christmas are mostly dark. Candles and artificial lights are used in abundance, and the season is known as the Festival of Light. On December 13th, when the days begin to lengthen, the festivities begin with Lucia, usually the oldest daughter of each home, serving steaming hot coffee and special buns from household to household. The other children in the family also participate as attendants and star boys. Lucia wears a white robe, a symbol of purity, a red sash, a symbol of faith, and greens on her crown, a symbol of everlasting life, and lighted candles as a symbol of the light and hope for all mankind. Legend has it that the first Lucia lived in Sicily, Italy, about 300 AD. As a young girl, she had heard about Jesus Christ and the light of the world and became a Christian. She dedicated her life to helping the poor and the needy. When she was 17 years old, she was engaged to a wealthy Roman nobleman. But Lucia was dedicated to Christian charitable work, giving away all she had, even her wedding dress, to those in need. Her fiancé was enraged by what Lucia had done. He demanded that she give up this foolish obsession. When she refused to denounce Christ, he turned her over to Roman officers who were persecuting Christians. Lucia was jailed, tortured, and blinded, but she maintained her faith in Christ. Her persecutors attempted to burn her at the stake, but even through the flames that covered her, she was not burned. Her faith in Jesus remained strong. Lucia was miraculously healed of her blindness, and her tormentors became more angry and fearful of the swiftness of the power of Christ. They had her put to death by the sword in the arena on December 13, 304. But even in her death, her face glowed like the light she had become, and she became known as the Queen of Light. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. We come with these lighted candles to witness to the greatest light that has come to this dark world, God's light, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who gave his life for our sins to bring light to a darkened world. Because of Christmas, because Jesus came, we have light in this world of darkness.
Kids just here for just a minute. Just wait another second. We're going to pray, and then we would like to invite all of you to come over for some refreshments in the Family Center. And on your way out, whatever door you go, there's a box of apples, and we invite you to take an apple and enjoy that as a gift from the Sunday School. Let's pray as we close. Thanks, God, for being here with us. Thanks for each child, for each family. May your blessings go with us as we celebrate this special season. In Jesus' name, amen.